Joining us is former CIA Director James Woolsey. James, good to see you. Thanks for being here this morning. All right, sure. So did the Obama administration make the right move here? I mean, some say they went too far, some say they didn't go far enough.
Well, there's a certain kabuki dance aspect to all this. What the Obama administration did to the Russians was require that a number of the official cover officers leave, that is, people who are undercover as military officers or as civil servants for Russia. And that's kind of standard. You can't arrest them and prosecute them because they have diplomatic immunity. And then we closed down one of their weekend retreats, that's about it. There's it's kind of pro forma, and PR. It's lots of public statements requiring them to cut it out. By the way, I don't think "cut it out" is exactly the phrase you want to use with a former KGB officer like Putin.
Yeah, that was an interesting choice of words for sure.
Yeah, he may think it's okay for him to cut something out.
So let's talk, James, about what Trump's going to do here, because I mean, this is Obama acting in the very final days of his administration, as we know. And Trump put out a statement. He said, look, it's time to move on. We've got more important things to do. Yet he did say he's going to hold these meetings with intelligence officials next week. What do you make of that? He has already been a skeptic of what has been coming out of our intelligence agencies.
Well, I think whatever else he does, he ought not to talk about it. That's part of what's been so screwy here, is that the verbal activity is substantially in excess of what is actually occurring in terms of any kind of retaliation. I think that there's really a situation brewing that has to be brought under control. But the way to do it is not to have more and more public statements about it. It's, if we have to retaliate, and there are some things we ought to do here, we ought to do them without saying anything about it. We ought to speak softly, carry a big stick, and occasionally use the stick.
What needs to be brought under control? Because there's some confusion as to what exactly did transpire. It wasn't the election that was actually hacked, right? It was John Podesta, Hillary Clinton's campaign manager, right, that was hacked, and the DNC was hacked. It wasn't the actual election, as so many people report. So what you're talking about, this serious problem, I know you're right, referring to cybersecurity, but what really is the root of the problem that we're trying to address here?
As far as we know, they did not do such things as create mythical voters by using dead people's identities the way that has happened in Chicago from time to time over the centuries. They didn't do anything like that. They may have tried, who knows, but there's been no report that they did anything successfully from their point of view that way. We do need, the first and most important thing we need to do is to fix our voting machines, because in the aftermath of the hanging chads in Florida election of 2000, a lot of localities fixed their voting machines, but they fixed them to use touch screens without any paper trail. So that means if the Russians in 2 years get somebody inside our system and start playing with totals, there's no way to check it. All of the various entities, voting organizations and groups and counties and states and so forth that run the elections need to be looking at 2 years from now, and to have a system which can't be hacked in a way that will directly affect the outcome of the election.
James, if I could jump in. Dominic Tavell, how are you? Just to bring it back to this Obama administration reaction, I mean, they clearly knew this pre-election. They didn't wake up yesterday morning and go, wow, we just found this out. So why now? Why are they reacting now? Why didn't you react 2 months ago, 3 months ago, 4 months ago?
I don't know. Maybe they want they like the PR now rather than otherwise. The main thing they ought to be doing is hardening the electricity grid so the Russians can't, or others can't, hack into the grid and shut down our electricity the way they have for Ukraine, for example. Those are what's important, not the verbiage, not when they say it, not even what they say. It's our vulnerabilities that have to get fixed.
James, this is Rachel Campos Duffy here. The hacking of OPM by the Chinese appears to be a much worse case. So why no sanctions there?
I don't know. I mean, I cannot get inside the head of the Obama administration at all. I have great difficulty with that. But the sanctions don't do much good. We don't trade that much with Russia, so cutting off contacts with American corporations doesn't really mean anything. This is all, like I said, it's a kabuki dance. If you want to do something effective, take physical measures to keep your systems from getting dealt with and getting changed and getting fiddled with by the Russians or the Chinese or anyone. Keep quiet about what you're doing, and when you have an opportunity to cause great trouble for them the way they have for you, go ahead and do it and don't say a word about it.
Wow. So would you say that this is about causing more trouble for Donald Trump than it is for the Russians?
I can't tell why the Obama administration would think that it was causing particular trouble for Trump by doing this. It's how, why, what does it do for them?
Well, it sort of puts him into a diplomatic corner, if you will, obviously a few days before he takes office. This is something we're going to be watching, obviously, very closely. And James Woolsey, great to get your perspective on that. As the former director of Central Intelligence, this is something that's going to be dealt with for some time. Good to see you. Happy New Year.